Please raise your right hand. Do you swear that the testimony that you are about to give shall be the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth, so help you God?
I do.
Thank you. Let the record show that the witness answered in the affirmative. Our only witness today is Mr. Sundar Pichai. Mr. Pichai is the Chief Executive Officer of Google. Your written statement will be entered into the record in its entirety, and we ask that you summarize your testimony in 5 minutes. To help you stay within that time, there's a timing light on your table. When the light switches from green to yellow, you have 1 minute to conclude your testimony. When the light turns red, it signals your 5 minutes have expired. Mr. Pichai, you are very welcome, and you may begin.
Chairman Goodluck, Ranking Member Nadler, distinguished members of the committee, thank you for the opportunity to be here today. I joined Google 15 years ago, and I've been privileged to serve as CEO for the past 3 years. But my love for information and technology began long before that. It's been 25 years since I made the US my home. Growing up in India, I have distinct memories of when my family got its first phone and its first television. Each new technology made a profound difference in our lives. Getting the phone meant I could call ahead to the hospital to check that the blood results were in instead of taking a 2-hour trip there. And the television, well, it only had one channel, but I couldn't have been more thrilled by its arrival. Those experiences made me a technology optimist, and I remain one today. Not only because I believe in technology, but because I believe in people and their ability to use technology to improve their lives. I'm incredibly proud of what Google does to empower people around the world, especially here in the US. I'd like to take a moment to share a bit of background on that. 20 years ago, two students, one from Michigan and one from Maryland, came together at Stanford with a big idea: to provide users with access to the world's information. That mission still drives everything we do, whether that's saving you a few minutes on your morning commute or helping doctors detect disease and save lives. Today, Google is more than a search engine. We are a global company that's committed to building products for everyone. That means working with many industries, from education and healthcare to manufacturing and entertainment. Even as we expand into new markets, we never forget our American roots. It's no coincidence that a company dedicated to free flow of information was founded right here in the US. As an American company, we cherish the values and freedoms that have allowed us to grow and serve so many users. And I'm proud to say we do, and we will continue to work with the government to keep our country safe and secure. Over the years, our footprint has expanded far beyond California to states such as Texas, Virginia, Oklahoma, and Alabama. Today in the US, we are growing faster outside of the Bay Area than within it. I've had the great opportunity to travel across the country and see all the places that are powering our digital economy, from Clarksville to Pittsburgh to San Diego, where we recently launched a partnership with the USO to help veterans and military families. Along the way, I've met many people who depend on Google to learn new skills, find jobs, or new businesses. Over the past year, we have supported more than 1.5 million American businesses. And over the past 3 years, we have made direct contributions of $150 billion to the US economy, added more than 24,000 employees, and paid over $43 billion to our US partners across Search, YouTube, and Android. These investments strengthen our communities and support thousands of American jobs. They also allow us to provide great services to our users to help them through the day. It's an honor to play this role in people's lives. And it's one we know comes with great responsibility. Protecting the privacy and security of our users has long been an essential part of our mission. We've invested an enormous amount of work over the years to bring choice, transparency, and control to our users. These values are built into every product we make. We recognize the important role of governments, including this committee, in setting rules for the development and use of technology. To that end, we support federal privacy legislation and proposed a legislative framework for privacy earlier this year. Users look to us to provide accurate, trusted information, and we work hard to ensure the integrity of our products. We have put a number of checks and balances in place to ensure they continue to live up to our standards. I lead this company without political bias, and work to ensure that our products continue to operate that way. To do otherwise would be against our core principles and our business interests. We are a company that provides platforms for diverse perspectives and opinions, and there is no shortage of them amongst our employees. Some Googlers are former servicemen and women who have risked much in defense of their country. Some are civil libertarians who fiercely defend freedom of expression. Some are parents who worry about the role technology plays in our households. Some, like me, are immigrants who are profoundly grateful to the freedoms and opportunities it offers. And some of us are many of these things. Let me close by saying that leading Google has been the greatest professional honor of my life. It's a challenging moment for our industry, but I'm privileged to be here. I greatly appreciate you letting me share the story of Google and our work to build products worthy of the trust users place in us. Thank you for the opportunity, and I look forward to answering your questions.